I guess there's a number of different ways we could do this. I can talk a little bit about the Totnes pound, but I think the really exciting stuff is when you start thinking about what would it be like if I were to design my own local currency. What sort of attributes would it have? And I mean, who was there for there was a comment. My mind's just gone. Somebody was talking about local a currency. Oh, no, that was in the economics discussion that was in room 15 just a minute ago. Was anybody in that one?
Yeah.
Okay, so there was a guy from Zero Carbon Britain there who talked about how currencies and the design of currencies inherently affect the economies and the environment that they belong to. And he said that it's no coincidence that the Western industrial world has huge debts because the currency is built up on debt. It's a debt-based currency. But maybe we don't need that. Maybe there are more equitable ways of spending money that will design more equitable economies. So, I'm going to suggest something, and then you can tell me whether you think that's a good idea or not. I'll talk a little bit about the Totnes pound. I'll talk a little bit about the nature of money. I will keep it to a minimum. And then what we could do is we could open up to discussions on the table about the three or four things that you'd look for if you were designing your own local currency. You know, would you have interest? Would you have demurrage? Would you not? I'll explain what those words are. And maybe you can, if I distribute some bits of paper, you may not have enough. Well, if we could designate one person to write up, and then we can sort of just go around the room, if we manage the time properly, and each take a little bit of talk about what they think their currency might look like. Does that sound like a good idea? Yeah? Anybody vehemently disagree with that? That's good. Consensus in the room, just about. Okay, so the Totnes pound, I've got...
Show me my hand, mate.
Just move it up. I've got some flyers on the Totnes pound here, which I'll just pass around, and which you can spend your time reading while I'm talking. So, the Totnes pound was inspired by a guy called Bernard Lyotard. Has anybody heard of Bernard Lyotard? Okay, a few people. He's like a real guru on local money. Brilliantly humorous Belgian. Has anybody ever heard of one of those before? Probably they're not supposed to be very have senses of humour, but he belies that stereotype. And what he said is that you can't relocalize a community without having your own money. And you can't have a successful local currency unless it's attractive to business. And it was kind of those were the two design criteria that we used right at the start for the Totnes pound. So for example, who's experienced a local an alternative complementary currency? Okay? Right, everybody in the room should have their hand up. Yeah. Everybody in this room has experience of a complementary currency. How many people have bought vouchers or used vouchers? Right. How many people have used air miles? How many people have used... Come on, there must be someone. Okay, I have. But I don't fly anymore, so you know I'm sort of repaying my ecological debt to the biosphere at the moment. Can anybody think of any other complementary currencies?
Nectar points,
rewards cards.
Green
shield stamps. I've not heard anybody use those three words for about 25 years, I think. Amazing. Let system. Okay, so
IOUs.
That's an interesting one, isn't it? So let me ask that question again. Is there anybody in this room who has not used a complementary currency of some kind? You haven't?
No, have.
You should. You should go.
Thanks so much. In a way, we're shopping with coupons and stuff like that. And
well, there we go, coupons. Yeah. So it's out there. Does anybody know what the second biggest currency in the world is? Is the dollar? No, it's air miles. Which is extraordinary, which is very, very sad indictment of where we are in terms of ecological devastation and how we're supporting it economically. So, where was it? Design of the Totnes plan. So initially, it was just that design criteria, let's get it. If we're going to relocalise, we're going to need a local economy. We've got to make it attractive to business. So those people who have been involved in LET schemes, which I guess is an alternative currency or complementary currency, has anybody found that they were attractive to business?
Sorry, what are the LETs?
Oh, a LET. Who has been involved in a LET scheme? There we go. You came in right at the right time. Okay, so don't sit down. Tell these people you've got 30 seconds to explain what a LET scheme is.
It's the exchange of trades and things without using local currency.
Okay.
So you invent your own local currency, which in Bath was the Oliver, and you give it a value, which was 25 Olivers equal an hour's labour, and then you get all the people in Bath to list their skills and the amount they want for the labour, for the skill per hour, so babysitting 25 Olivers an hour, brain surgery, 17 Olivers an hour. And then you put out a directory with a contact number, and people contact each other and swap skills sort of directly. And you pay for it with the local currency, which goes to like a local bank, and you get a plus and a negative. Well, you don't get a negative, you get a debit and a credit on your own system. Will that do? Sorry, it's more than 30 seconds.
I was enthralled, so that sounds like a very...
And it works, sort of.
Okay, really?
Not very well. But
the question we were answering here was basically, if you want to relocalise your local economy, then you need local currency. And to be successful, local currency has... What should we ask her to present? We just put somebody on the spot. You're lucky you got away with that one. And it was really where it had to be attractive to business, because that's where most of the transactions are. You know, one side of the equation will be business, or maybe both sides of the equation. So how attractive was LET to business? Did you have any businesses involved? Or?
We had one or two businesses, but it was really unattractive because they didn't understand it. And we, rather foolishly in Bath, set it against labour rather than... a lot of them are linked to the pound, which people understand. So presumably we've got a wonderful Totnes pound. But ours was linked to an hour's labour, so the businesses really couldn't get their heads around that. Also the question of VAT and tax.
Right.
And sorry, in Bath we don't have local businesses.
Yes,
you
do. Well, one local business, or two, because I'm one as well.
Right. So when you say the wonderful Totnes pound, is that how people describe it now, the wonderful, like the sensational Alex Harvey band? If anybody else remembers it, it's the same as the Green Shield stamps with three people in the room who remembers it. So, initially, 300 Totnes pounds were given away into circulation. And this is the hottest... Does anybody here understand money, or reckons they're like 50% of the way to understanding it? Yeah, okay. Yeah, how much time have you spent doing that?
Quite a bit, actually.
Yeah, quite a bit. In order to get there, it's a really interesting thing, which you have to. It's like clearing a piece of land. We've got so much garbage and crap we're told about money, and you have to clear all that away before you can start thinking about, thinking clearly about it. We gave it away into circulation, and it was really. To start conversations, 300 Totnes pounds isn't exactly going to turn around the local economy. I mean, that's not what it was designed to do. It's designed to to raise people's awareness and start asking questions about money, which is really, really crucial.